Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. From today, we are going to start a tutorial series on STAAD.Pro, and this is the first tutorial of the series. We will have a brief introduction of STAAD.Pro software and its user interface in this tutorial. If you don't have STAAD.Pro software, then go to my channel. The first video will show you the download link and the full procedure of installation process. Anyway, STAAD.Pro stands for Structural Analysis and Design Program. First, we analyze a structure, then design it through STAAD.Pro. The company Bentley invented this software. It can analyze and design of building, bridges, steel structures, frames, roofs, and so on. Once you open this software, you will get this window. You can open this software from Start menu or your desktop icon after installing it. On the first page of STAAD.Pro software, you will get four fields named Project Tasks, Help Topics, Recent Files, License Configuration, and STAAD News. To start a new project, you have to click on this New Project option. Or if you want to continue an existing project, then you will use this Open Project option. And from here, the Configuration option, you can change the configuration of your program. The main thing we have to change, that is base unit. To analyze and design a structure, we need to know two things: length of a member and force that is being applied on that member. So we have to set two units, that is length unit and another one is force unit. If you want to take your length as meter and the force as kilonewton, then you have to select metric option. Or if you want to take length as feet and force as pound, then you have to choose English option. I'm choosing the first one, metric option. I'm clicking here. From this dialog box, we can change global axis orientation also. I'm choosing the Y direction up. You can change also that in Z direction up. Another things we need to change, that is design codes. STAAD.Pro is being used worldwide, but there are individual design codes for different region. So you have to select that one which one is being followed for your country. Later we can change all these options also, so now just keep these options as they are, and I'm clicking on apply, then accept. From this field recent files, you will see the list of existing projects that you worked in previous. If you need any answer of your questions or any kind of help, then you can use these options. You will get a lot of tutorials also. And here is your license configuration. I'm clicking all of these options. From this STAAD News, you will get update of STAAD.Pro software, but you need an internet connection for this. Anyway, now I am going to open a new project. So I am clicking here. Then we will get this dialog box, and we have to choose on option from these four options. If you are working on three-dimensional framed structures with loads applied in any plane, then you have to choose space option. But if you want to work on XY plane for a 2D structure, then you have to choose plane option. We will learn everything step by step, so we are just starting our project on 2D plane. So I select on plane, then come here, and I have to give a name of my structure. First of all, we will design a beam as a beginner, so I am just naming it as beam design. Then you have to specify the location where you want to save this file. Before that, make sure that you have created a specific folder, because STAAD.Pro creates a lot of multiple files for a single file. So if you save STAAD.Pro file in an open place like desktop or in a drive, then it will not look good. So you have to create a specific folder to save all these files. And come here for units. There is two type of units, as I said earlier. For length unit I am choosing meter, and for force unit I am choosing kilonewton. Then we are done, and I will go to the next step. That's why I am clicking on next option. All kind of frames, whether it is beam or column, that is considered as beam in STAAD.Pro, and slabs are considered as plate. You can choose any option from these options, because we can change this option later inside the program. As starting, I am choosing add beam option, then I go for finish. And then you will get this window, and this is user interface of STAAD.Pro. In this window, top here there is title bar. Then you will get a lot of toolbars here. These various tools are in the form of icon. Here is also a toolbar that is called selection toolbar. This row is called mode bar, and these vertical two lines are called page controller. And this area is called data area. This is node table, and this is beam table. This is the main white area where we work, where we draw, and this is called workspace. First you have to draw a structure that you want to design, and first you have to draw it, and the first step of drawing it is geometry. We will start drawing a beam from the next video, so I am closing it. We will also use these toolbars and options later, and everything will be clear to you. Combination of all these options toolbars is being called as GUI, which stands for graphical user interface of STAAD.Pro. Okay everyone, this is all for today. We will discuss more about STAAD.Pro in the next video.